Well, our next guest loved Lego so much as a kid. He's made a career of it. Ryan McNaught blew us away the last time we had him on the show, so we couldn't wait to get him back. Please welcome Ryan, the Brick Man McNaught, to Studio 10. Hello. You made this. You are a superstar.
I mean, that is amazing.
This wasn't always your job, though, was it?
No. I used to be one of those long-suffering people in the corporate world, and I knew I'd had enough when I had a meeting about how many meetings we were having. That gave me the secret signal that it's time to do something else.
Yeah, but you're now a certified Lego professional. What do you have to do to become a certified Lego professional?
So there's 12 of us in the world, and we each got our job in a totally different way, so there's no, like, set path. You don't go to Lego University or something awesome like that. But I was very lucky. Many years ago, when the iPad was first released, I wrote a piece of software to allow kids to use the iPad to control robotic Lego. So some guys from Lego saw it and said, come in for a chat.
This koala that you have made, I'm so tempted to...
Careful.
Is it? Have you glued it?
This one is, because it had to go in my luggage to get up here.
Wow. You went in your luggage?
Absolutely.
I love this, because for kids... Wow. They don't think in 2D.
Get your hands off, Jess. Sit down.
But kids don't think in 2D, do they? They think in 3D, and this teaches them form and architecture and strength and engineering and everything. I think it's great for kids.
Yeah, the spatial awareness.
But you're not a kid.
Well, everyone's a kid in some way or another.
Oh,
but,
good on you.
Yeah.
How much did it take?
The koala, we're not sure if it's a boy or a girl, by the way. We haven't come up with a name yet.
Would you like me to check that out?
You can. Would you like some bricks and you can...
Oh, yeah, sure.
Don't you break it,
Tony. Hold on. No, I won't.
Well, if they can stop manhandling that poor koala. You've made something special for us, but you need some help. We're finishing it off.
I have indeed. I've made the Studio 10 logo.
Which
is around somewhere. Here it comes, over there.
Oh,
there we go.
Wow.
And Jono has been super busy himself.
Oh no.
Jeez.
Oh my goodness.
Why does Jono have a drink?
Robert pushed me.
I promise I didn't touch
you. He tripped me over. Oh, my, okay, all right.
Looks like my job's safe for a while anyway.
I can put them back together. Just get them back.
Where do you get your ideas from?
Well, the good thing is things like this, it's everyday objects, so anything sort of around. And watching, I'm quite proud to be the parents of twins, so my kids always come up with amazing ideas, you know. Mm. One day it's a spaceship, the next it's a car, then it's a piece of furniture.
How long did it take
you
to make the bit?
That was about a week and a bit. So,
do you know, I've bought several over the years because they're now creating these architectural icons from around the world, right? You can build the Empire State Building, or you can build, the Eiffel Tower. It's great for kids.
Yeah, and the thing is, it's so versatile. You know, 1 minute that could be the Eiffel Tower, the next minute they can turn that into, a coffee mug. So
has Lego improved? I mean, it seems to me the bricks are, slightly more technical.
The same bricks haven't changed for 50-odd years.
Right.
However, they've added more bricks to the palette. So,
and girl Legos.
Absolutely. They have a lot of girl Lego. And if I can
I like all that girl Lego.
If I can share a secret with you and the audience on its own, girls are better at Lego than boys.
Oh. Why is that?
Really?
Girls understand colour concepts and matching colours and the rest, whereas if you look at a structure a boy makes, it's just all over the place, red, blue, yellow, whatever, whereas girls will think about colour and how it applies and shading and texture and that kind of stuff.
Are you saying that girls are better designers than boys?
No. No. I've still got my original Lego. And in fact, when I first started going out with girls, they used to say Lego. Hey, Jono, Lego.
Does Jono go out with girls?
Yeah. Very.
He has a very vivid imagination.
Lego, Jono.
Try and fix that, Jono.
Yeah.
That's the executive producer. We've got to come up with a name for this koala.
Yeah, so we haven't given a name to the koala yet, a boy or a girl. So we're running a competition online at brickmanexperience.com.au and name the koala.
Oh,
nice.
I'm going to go Moriah.
Ryan, thank you so much for joining us. It's a great idea to take the kids to one of these exhibitions. Your exhibition is actually at City Town Hall later in the month.
Starting on Saturday for 2 weeks at Sydney Town Hall, we've got 60 sculptures. This is a bit of a baby compared to some of the other sculptures which we've got on display. So come on down and get your building fingers ready. There's lots for people to build.
Great school holiday activity.
Yes,
yeah.
Brickmanexperience.com.au. Ryan, thanks very much for coming in. In the world of entertainment now with Angela Bishop. What's coming up, Ange?
Well, they're about to heat up the big screen. We hear from the boys from Magic Mike. Which actor is about to pull on Spider-Man's red lycra? And we remember the man behind some of Hollywood's greatest theme songs. That's all coming up in entertainment.
Thanks a lot, Ange. You're watching Studio 10. Thanks to Gloria Jean's Coffees. They're celebrating their second birthday of their smooth and creamy Sereno blend. Get one free between today and between 2 and 3 every day in June. Lego, Ange, Lego.